Are we on, David? Are we on? This morning, our words for gathering are from Ken Collier. I do not know where we go when we die, and I do not know what the soul is, or what death is, or why. What I know is that the song once sung cannot be unsung, and the life once lived cannot be unlived, and the love once loved cannot be unloved. Let us worship together. If you're joining us on Zoom, you may wish to light a chalice now. Our chalice lighting words for this morning are: we light this chalice this morning in memory of those members of our Emerson community who have gone on before us. Those names fill our memories, and those whose names we honor as part of our history, whose faith built this church, sustained and changed this church in countless ways. As this sanctuary holds our memories of them, our chalice holds a flame. May it burn here as part of our worship, as a reminder of all the ways in which their lives continue to be part of this beloved community. Please stand while we recite our covenant in English and in Spanish. Love is the doctrine of this church. The quest for truth is its sacrament, and service is its prayer. To dwell together in peace, to seek knowledge in freedom, to serve humanity in fellowship, thus do we covenant. La doctrina de esta iglesia es el amor. La búsqueda de la verdad es su sacramento, y el servicio es su oración. Vivir juntos en paz, buscar el conocimiento en libertad, servir a la humanidad en comunión, este es nuestro pacto. Our opening hymn this morning is When the Summer Sun is Shining, number 66 in the gray hymnal.
When the summer sun is shining over golden land and sea, and the flowers in the hedgerow welcome butterfly and bee, then my open heart is glowing, full of warmth for everyone. And I feel an inner beauty which reflects the summer sun. When the summer clouds of thunder bring the long-awaited rain, and the thirsty soil is moistened and the grass is green again, then I long for summer sunshine, but I know that clouds and tears are a part of life's refreshment, like the rainbow's hopes and fears. In the cool of summer evening, when the dancing insects play, and in garden, street, and meadow linger echoes of the day, then my heart is full of yearning, hope and memories flood the whole. of my being, reaching inwards to the corners of my soul.
Good morning. Welcome to Emerson Unitarian Universalist Church. This morning we are together again, both in person and online on Zoom, to spend time in worship. I'm Linda Fitzgerald, and I'd like to welcome all of you to what has been in the past an annual Memorial Day service in which we acknowledge loved ones who have passed on before us, and keep the sacrifices of those who have served our country in combat or as enlisted military close in our hearts and minds. This service was co-created by our beloved past minister, Ann Felton Hines, and Tracy Davis many years ago. And I'm so happy that we're able to revive it and bring it to you in person, as well as virtually. The service has many elements, and as an in-person service is lovely and worshipful. We are hoping to bring some measure of that worshipful memorial service to you on Zoom also, as well as those present here. Emerson is an inclusive liberal religious community, fondly named for the transcendentalist minister and author Ralph Waldo Emerson. We have been a bright beacon of liberal justice and a spiritual home in the West San Fernando Valley for over 65 years. We acknowledge that we are located on the land of Chumash, Tongva, and Keech peoples' land, which remains part of their lasting identity and heritage. Our existence as a spiritual community can never fully be understood without appreciating the depth of the loss of their land in generations past and the enduring hopes for the renewed vitality of these cultures in years to come. This morning marks the return of our wonderful minister, Reverend Matthew McHale. He's returning after 5 months on a sabbatical. Unfortunately, we're unable to see Reverend Matthew in person as he's home recovering from COVID. He assured me that he expects to be back in the pulpit here next Sunday, and he is going to give us some words later in the service. We look forward to hearing all about your sabbatical in the coming weeks. Welcome home, Matthew. If you're new here or visiting, please know how happy we are to welcome you this morning. I hope you have signed our guest book in the foyer, or if you are joining online, please sign our virtual guest book, which is located in the chat. Also included in the chat is a link to our online Book of Life, where you can enter a joy or concern you'd like read aloud this morning. For those of you visiting in person today, our Book of Life is located on the table under the memorial wall. After the service, members of the finance team will be available to talk about the budget in advance of the congregational meeting. In the inspirational words of Patricia Sheldon, "For those we miss, for things long gone, for those or who or what we last held in our arms, in our hands and in our hearts, we pray. We pray for memories to stay strong, memories of words and warmth, of actions and stillness. Whether you're a longtime member or a first-time visitor, welcome one and all."
Morning. These offering words are adapted from Kristen Collins. We give to remind ourselves how many gifts we have to offer. We give to remember that we are part of something bigger than ourselves, and to remember those who have gone before us. We give because we believe in music and memory and sacred space. We give with the faith that together we have enough. We will now receive an offering for the support of this religious community and its work in the world. Your generosity is greatly appreciated. For those of you at home, you may give by using the Vanco mobile app on our website at emersonuuc.org/donate or by mailing a check to the church. The ushers may now come forward to receive the offer.
From you I receive, to you I give, together we share, and from this we live.
We take time this week to light this memorial candle. For those who passed away during the pandemic and those suffering in our wider community.
When we gather here on a Sunday morning, each of us brings with us sorrows and joys in our hearts, in our homes, our communities, and our world. We open our worship to all that life brings, and we set aside this time to bring these pieces of our lives into this space. For those of you who are on Zoom, you can take some time to write any joys or sorrows that you have in the virtual book of life or in the chat. It does appear that Dave and Sandy Ginsburg had they wrote, wishing Ivar Ringdahl strength after his surgery from colon cancer. And in our book of life here at Emerson, Todd Covert wrote, is thrilled that his sister Wendy got good news in her cancer treatment with her latest scan 2 years after her diagnosis. That's a wonderful news. Also, please send healing energy to Kevin Mathey, our pianist, who is still fighting cancer. And Pam Randall wrote, prayers for my 2-year-old great-grandson who was killed Monday in an accident, and my granddaughter, Brittany, who is grieving. I'm so sorry to hear that. Oh my gosh. If there is a person or an event that you want to put forward into this space, you can take the time to say the name, and we'll send love and healing out to our wider community. Pam Randall, Brittany, Ivan Ringdahl, Dorothy. So may it be among us. This morning, we acknowledge the names inscribed on the memorial plaque in our sanctuary. Those members of our Emerson community who have passed away over the 40 years. We will begin and end with the words by UU Minister Catherine A. Schmitz. On this day, let us pause to remember those who have come before us, those who have helped to bring us to where we are today, members of our families, members of this community, friends, neighbors, leaders. Here, or today, as we look toward the future,
I'm looking for my list. Thank you. Mm-hmm. Let's start by reading the names of the people contained on that wall. Ada Bell Clark Welsh, Alan Bradley Kaufman, Don Myers, Wilma Ricker, Charlene Eckerson, Aaron Z. Klain, Kelly, Irene M. Klain, Susie, Reverend Frank Ricker and Edith Bunny Ricker, Vera Green and John H. Green, Carlo Bartoletti, Paul Hyatt, Kathleen B.B. Sexton and Jewel Newman Sexton, Kenneth K. Spielman, Doris Vitti Miller, Milton Miller, Paul Berge and Miriam Berge, Christopher John Shahanian, Rose Williams, Reverend Brooks Walker, Guy Snowden Miller, Reverend David M. Mencher, Helen Mencher, Ellis Chris Columbus, Charles Vernon Moore, Harry S. Chalice, Dr. William Earl Moore, Donna Henderson, Dale Pedrotti and Shirley Pedrotti, Mary Trumpler and Alfred Oswald Trumpler, Craig West and Doris West, Ed Turchin and Fran Turchin, John Earl Newfer, Martin Henderson.
Continuing, Marilyn Kaufman and Erwin Kaufman, Eileen Martin, Jackie Wild, Henry Smith and Katharina Lale Smith, Jack Byram and Dorothy Bess Byram, Carol Trumbull and Don Trumbull, Stan Chalice and Kathleen Chalice, Clara Louise Gillespie and Edmund Stanley Gillespie, John H. Abbott and Louise E. Rana, Lloyd Henry Geisen, Neil Vandercook, Gary Dean Wynn, Warren Richard Schmidt and Hermelie Schmidt, Willis E. Sims and Melba Angeline Sims, Ruth M. Patrick, Jackie Erickson, Margaret Moore, Mary Joan Noonan, Edwin Shaughnessy, Leo Maggio, Sue Keating, Sarah Smith, Virginia Sinclair, Shirley K. Brown and S. Leon Brown, Diana Dixon Davis, Cornelia Sandy Vandenberg, Jane Benz, Elizabeth Fitzmaurice and Walter Fitz Fitzmaurice, Ruth Elizabeth Cook, Karen Jean Kaufman, Bert Siskin, Dorothy E. Lyon, Barbara Naomi Tober, Rod Zimmerman, Charles Philip Moore, Robert E. Caraway, M.D., and Elizabeth Barrett Caraway.
Edgar Eddie Ettinger, John Cameron Gunn, Richard Rob Hake, Alvin Lindenhauer, Donald S. Ordway, Meredith Graham, Judy Coven Ringdahl, Betty Marote, Phyllis Durham, and Gail Silva. Today, as we look toward the future, we give thanks for the past and the legacy we are blessed to continue. May we live our lives so that they have mattered in large ways and in small, in ways we may never know.
I think we have Arlington, a video created and edited by Philip Koreski with Hap Palmer, Mia Forbes, and others.
Do you know?
This Memorial Day weekend, we as a nation honor those who have given their lives in service to our country. Here at Emerson, it's our tradition to mark this weekend by remembering all our loved ones who have died, which we have done in the reading of their names, to honor our memories of them and celebrate their lives. We have named those who are on our memorial plaque, but our lives are filled with memories of many more friends and family members, as well as those who have shared this church community with us. Before we begin, I've placed a vase with 19 red roses and 2 white star mums on our altar, representing the lost souls of the 19 children and 2 teachers from Robb Elementary School in Uvalde, Texas this week. Reverend Matthew, please help us calm our hearts with your words.
It is so good to be with you again, even if COVID prevents me from being there in the sanctuary with you this morning. And it was great to hear the music of this community again. Mia Forbes, Hap Palmer, Brianna Bandy, Adam Nissenholtz, Rhonda Plank Richard. And yet, my heart is heavy today, as I'm sure are so many of yours. Still reeling from the shooting in Buffalo, where 10 black people were murdered and 3 more injured, and the shooting at a Taiwanese American Presbyterian church in Orange County that killed 1 and injured 5, wounds still fresh and raw, we are faced with a new heartbreak, with the senseless murder of 19 children and 2 teachers at Robb Elementary School in Uvalde, Texas. In the spirit of this morning's service, we lift up their names. Nevaeh Bravo, 10. Her name is Heaven, spelled backwards. She loved to make people smile. Xavier Lopez, 10. Loved cracking jokes and dancing cumbia. Eva Mireles, age 44. An educator for 17 years, she taught 4th graders at Robb Elementary School and loved running, hiking, and bike riding. Jose Flores, 10, was a 4th grader who loved to play baseball. Eli Garcia, 9, loved singing and dancing. Tess Mata, 10, loved spending time with family. Lexi Rubio, 10, was a standout student and an athlete who played basketball and softball. Jaila Silguero, 10, loved pink and playing games. Irma Garcia, 48, was a 4th grade teacher at Robb Elementary. She loved to cook and fish and teach youngsters how to read. And 2 days later, her husband, Joe Garcia, died of a heart attack not long after leaving flowers at the memorial outside the elementary school. Jacqueline Cáceres, 9, recently celebrated her first communion. J.C. Levanos, 10, made a pot of coffee for his grandparents, whom he lived with, every morning. Miranda Mathis, 11, was smart, fun, and spunky. Emery Joe Garza, 10, was an honor roll student, a proud big sister, and an all-around good kid. McKenna Lee Elrod, 10, loved to dance and sing. Lila Salazar, 10, won 6 races at the school's recent field day event. Maite Rodriguez, 10, dreamed of becoming a marine biologist. Annabelle Rodriguez, 10, was outgoing and loved to be the center of attention. Eliahana Cruz Torres, 10, loved playing softball and was hoping to make the all-star team. Rogelio Torres, 10, was a smart and loving child. Alicia Ramirez, 10, loved art and playing soccer. Lucia Garcia, 10, was getting ready for long days of football, swimming, video games, and whatever other fun the summer might offer. And there have been so many other lives lost to violence this year and in the years past, in a country where the annual death rate from guns is twice the number of people who died in the entirety of service members who died in the war in Afghanistan. On this weekend, Memorial Day weekend, when we remember the lives of those lost in service to our country, it is so important that we remember those lives taken needlessly, unnecessarily, tragically. I share the words from Reverend Anna Bladel from Enfleshed. None of this is normal. None of this is new. Even as so much is and feels unprecedented, all of this has been building for a long time, repairing, restoring. Healing is long, slow labor. Some losses can never be made right. Here we are. May we breathe, create, harbor, share nourishment. Savor the joy that finds us. Cultivate beauty where and how we can. Disrupt the shit that's killing us collectively and unequally. Tend life with fierce and tender care. Amen. Ashe. Blessed be.
If you wish to share a thought, story, or picture in our virtual service, please raise your hand and you will be unmuted and spotlighted by Linda Nelson. Those who are virtual, if they want to share a thought or story or a picture, they can unmute themselves and share with Linda Nelson. And then after they've shared about their loved ones, we will say the words, we remember them. Any takers, Linda Beth? No? Okay. We'll get to that. Linda.
If you wish, can we turn off the sound in the Zoom?
Sandy and Dave are showing a picture. I don't know if they want to speak. They're unmuted.
Sorry, I was trying to fix it and I messed it up. Okay, do you know how to fix it, Todd? Okay.
Hey, Sandy and Dave, I just spotlighted your video, but it was after you had already shared the pictures. So if you wanted to put those back up, I don't think people had a chance to see them.
Let's see if this is going to work. If you wish, you're invited to come forward. In silence, you may do that also.
to death. It's hard with the mask. This is to honor the death of Robert Dorman in a tragic suicide in July 23rd, 1979.
For my darling little great-grandson, who was killed on Monday. His name is Gabriel.
This is for my father-in-law, who passed away a few years ago. This was when he was in his youth. And anyways, he was very dear to us and to my daughters, who miss him very much.
I brought this photograph of myself and my mom. She died last November, and she was the president of the Assistance League after she retired from the county. And you can read about all the stuff that the Assistance League does there.
I have a picture of my cousin, Chris Light, who passed away 2 years ago tomorrow and was very brave and had a great attitude during her illness.
We remember them. This morning I brought a picture of Lloyd Geisen, who was a very, very dear choir director at Emerson for many, many years. He's pictured here with Mary Gleason, who is still very much alive. But we really, really had a wonderful choir. And this is a picture of my mother in her 94th year, all dressed up and ready for a luncheon, which was her favorite activity.
We remember them.
We remember them. Anyone else?
Jean and I brought four photos of, close to the mic. Jean and I brought four photos of people we've known since beginning 1967. The last was in 1972. Two were at our wedding. One was our minister for over 20 years in Maine and in Massachusetts. All had a real impact on our lives. The last of the minister passed away just last month. So we remember them. They are very much still with us.
We remember them.
This morning, I honor two people we've lost in our family in the past year. This is a photograph of my sister's husband with his family, Army veteran John Weiss, who died last fall. And this is the order of service from the memorial service for my mother, Kathleen Nelson, who died in January.
We remember them.
I light the candle really for my sister's health, my sister Wendy Heilman. But in doing so, I think of her father, my stepfather, the late Ronald Heilman, Dr. Ronald Heilman. This is a picture, so many of my memories are virtual these days. She loved her dad, my stepdad. He was the best man at my first wedding. And sadly, he was taken after a diagnosis in his 50s of cancer, just as my sister is now in her 50s, struggling down the same path. It's one of life's really, truly bitter ironies that she received the same sort of diagnosis that her beloved father, my stepfather, Ron, had. And I know that he is with her. However any of us think of this, however I think of that, I know that he is so much with her, and that he is such a source of strength for her in this. And I miss him, and I love him, and I carry him with me, too.
We remember them.
If we finish placing candles and objects on the altar, I have a reading by Margaret Mead. To the living, I'm gone. To the sorrowful, I will never return. To the angry, I was cheated. But to the happy, I'm at peace. And to the faithful, I have never left. I cannot be seen, but I can be heard. So as you stand upon a shore, gazing at a beautiful sea, remember me. As you look in awe at the mighty forest and its grand majesty, remember me. As you look upon a flower and admire its simplicity, remember me. Remember me in your heart, your thoughts, your memories of the times we loved, the times we cried, the times we fought, the times we laughed. For if you always think of me, I will never be gone. Our closing hymn is Blue Boat Home, which is in 1064 in the Teal.
Though below me I feel no motion, standing on these mountains and plains, far away from the rolling ocean, still my dry land heart can say, I've been sailing all my life now, never harbor or port have I known. Wide universe is the ocean I travel, and the earth is our blue boat home. Mother, sun, my sail, and moon, my rudder, as I ply the starry sea, leaning over the edge in wonder, casting questions into the deep, drifting here with my ship's companions, all we kindred pilgrim souls, making our way by the lights of the heavens in our beautiful blue boat home. I give thanks to the waves upholding me. Hail the great winds urging me on. Greet the infinite sea before me. Sing the sky my sailor's song. I was born upon the fathoms. Never harbor or port have I known. The wide universe is the ocean I travel, and the earth is our blue boat home.
Thank you to Tracy Davis, the person who created this service. You may be seated. Along with our former minister, Ann Felton Hines, and our associates today, Julie Borden, Melissa Marote, and our wonderful musicians, Hap Palmer, Mia Forbes, Rhonda Plank Richard, Kimberly Rosolo, Brianna Brandy, Kevin Matthew, and Adam Niesenholtz. Also, thanks to Conrad Niesenholtz, who is serving as our technical wizard today in the booth, got us back up and running, along with David Early. Thank you to everyone who participated. And if you would care to join us for coffee after the service, we'd love to meet you and chat. Also, you'll have a virtual coffee hour online.
As we extinguish our chalice, I give you these closing words by Elizabeth Clark Hardy. Sometime at eve. Sometime at eve, when the tide is low, I shall slip my mooring and sail away. With no response to the friendly hail of kindred craft in the busy bay. In the silent hush of the twilight pale, when the night scoops down to embrace the day, and the voices call in the waters flow, sometime in eve, when the tide is low, I shall slip my mooring and sail away. A few who have watched me sail away will miss my craft from the busy bay, some friendly barks that were anchored near, some loving souls that my heart held dear. In silent sorrow will drop a tear. But I shall have peacefully furled my sail in moorings sheltered from storm or gale, and greeted the friends who have sailed before over the unknown sea to the unseen shore.